Hi, my name's Jarrett Leiker. I'm a 16-time sport karate world champion. I've been training the martial arts for 21 years, and I'm a fourth-degree black belt in Okinawan Goju-Ryu, Japanese Karate Do, Jeet Taekwondo, and Okinawan Kabuto. I'd like to welcome you to my second volume of my rock-solid video series on competition bow staff. Today, we're going to be moving on to our intermediate to slightly advanced strikes, spins, and transitions that's going to help take your form and your sport karate game to the top level. As we get started, we're going to move into some of the advanced striking variations and moves that is going to help you take your form up to that top level. Okay, so the first thing we're going to start off with, we're going to do a quick review of our 8-strike combination, which you may have learned in our volume 1, if you did view that. So we're going to start out, we're going to do our advanced striking variation. We have two different ways that we grip. Okay, this was our basic grip that we went over in volume 1. Okay, I'll demonstrate the strikes here from a basic grip. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. And one more time from behind so you can follow along. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Some of the things that we went over are locking your strike up, meaning turning your wrist. This is unlocked and lock. You want to turn that down, turn that first knuckle over, right here. Okay, that was one of the very important things that we went over on volume 1, and also to make sure you're striking on your center line here. For the purposes of our intermediate and advanced level bow staff videos, we're going to move on to our advanced grip only, which is where we're sliding our hand. So I will demonstrate our 8-strike combination from our advanced grip. We're at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's our 8-strike combo. Now we're going to put on advanced variations, and the first one we're going to start with is called the hook. So what it's doing is we're going to change the ending of our 8-strike combo with every single one of these variations. So the first one on the hook, I will do this facing straight. So we're going to start out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now when we get to 6, this is where it changes. We're going to bring the bow right past our leg, like so, and hook. So let me do that from a side angle. We're on to our 6th strike, right here. And I'm going to bring the bow right past my leg. 1, and hook. Okay, so from behind, 1, and hook. So let's take the full combo of the 8-strike combo to hook. So I'm at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now this goes 7 and 8 all together. 7, 8. One more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So a little faster now. And we always want to hit strong on our first strike and our last strike. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One more time. And I won't count it this time, I'll just do it. One more time, from behind. Important thing that I'll look for is you want to make sure that your arm is completely straight, right across the plane here, okay? You don't want to hook up like this, okay? That's an uppercut, bring it here, okay? We are hooking, so as we come through, we come across. So one more time, I'll do it slow from every angle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And the final position. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. That is your eight strike combo, advanced variation, ending with the hook. Next up, we're going to continue on with our eight strike combo, advanced variations, and this ending is called the flick. Now you might say, I wonder why it's called the flick. So I'm going to first tell you why. This is called the bunkai. The application of this move is flicking or scooping sand into your opponent's eye. So at the end, I flick up. So let me demonstrate the whole combo and then we'll break it down. So I'm one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and I bring it down and up. So where I'm at is on seven, I'm taking it down at the ground and scooping the sand, okay, or flicking the sand. Okay, so let's take it from all angles and break it down. Ready? So I'm on a straight angle, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now a little bit stronger on this angle. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. One more time from behind. And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. So I'll do it full speed from two different angles, from the side and from the rear view. And from behind. Again, that's your eight strike combo, advanced variations, ending with the flip. Next up, we're going to take two moves that we learned in Volume 1, our beginner series, and we're going to couple them together into a really great combination. We're going to take our sweep and our eight strike combo, and we're going to put them together. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to start out and review the sweep really quick. All right, remember, standing from our side, all right, we want to make sure that on our sweep, our bow does not touch our body. So my first motion is I bring my bow up and bring my foot in. Okay, same sides, right and right. Bring it up and I bend my knees as I sweep. Again, the bunkai or application of this move is to sweep your opponent's feet out from underneath them. So from a forward view, here, slowly, okay, and from behind. Okay, so now let's take it with the full combo and then we'll put our dynamic ending on it. Okay, so we're going to set out here, forward. I'm going to sweep into the eight strike combination, slowly. Sweep, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. From a side view, and sweep, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay, now a little bit faster, and then we'll add our ending. I'll set from a side view. And full speed, I won't count this time. And go. I want you to watch two parts specifically, the beginning and the end. I always pause on one and on eight. So I begin and I end in the exact same spot. So I'm setting here, I will go full speed again. Now from behind. Now let's put on the advanced variation ending. One that we just went over, we had our flick and we had our hook. So we're going to go ahead and go with the hook. Let's take it all slow. I'm from a side position, and I'm going to sweep up, strike, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I'm going to turn and hook. Okay? The last time we were working on our hook, raising up, this time we're going to work on in a full stance. This is a great opening combo to start out your bow form. So I will set from the front, slowly. Sweep, strike, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, 8, all together. From behind, and sweep, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and I'm going to bring it across. Now you may have noticed I brought it up that time. Okay? Two different ways that you can do your hook. You can either bring it all the way from underneath your arm and hook, or bring it from here and hook. Think about it like boxing, all right, or sparring in the dojo. You either have short motions sometimes or you have big motions sometimes. All right? For the purpose of a bow staff and putting your form together, you want to make sure that you get a little bit of both. Okay, so let me go ahead and execute that full speed from all angles. Okay, now from the side. And the final angle from behind, so you can follow along and go. There's your 8-strike combos, advanced variations with the sweep. Next up, we're going to move into some of our advanced releases and spins and combinations. Our first thing that's up here is we're going to go into our behind-the-back pass to wrist roll release, okay? Or just easier said, the behind-the-back wrist roll or behind-the-back toss release, okay? So we're going to take it into three steps. We're going to do the behind-the-back itself, then we're going to do the behind-the-back to the wrist roll, and then we're going to do the behind-the-back wrist roll to release. Okay, so those three steps. Let's take the behind-the-back first. This is the most important part because momentum is the key when you're doing anything with your bow, especially when you're doing any spins or releases. Okay, so we're going to put the bow in our left hand. Okay, and this is best to be done so I can show it from behind. I'm going to take the bow, and I'm going to point it down like so. Okay, this is my motion. Down. One more time. Down. So when I start to come behind my back, very easily, down and grab. One more time. And grab. Now I'll show you from the front, a little faster. Okay? It's all, as you see, in this first motion. Right here, I'm bringing my bow up and I'm pushing. Okay, pushing. So listen for it, pushing. One more time, and pushing. All right, so that may feel a little awkward at first, but you really have to get that momentum built up with that. Otherwise, it's just going to be a really slow move, and it's going to make everything else really hard. Okay, so now that you've got that down, all right, you want to just practice it, and practice it some more. So now we're going to add on the hand roll or wrist roll. So I'm going to start out here again. I'm going to go to my side and behind my back and into my right hand and roll. Just a quick review from our last video on volume 1 where we did our wrist roll. Remember, we're pushing over with our thumb and our wrist going straight over the top. The names are interchangeable, wrist roll, hand roll, whichever you prefer. But I like to call it a wrist roll because that's where your momentum is coming off of. So I'm here and pushing. Remember, we have our clockwise this way, And another view. And then our counterclockwise, back the other way, and back the other way. For this release and combination, we're doing everything clockwise. So let me take it together. Behind the back to wrist roll. This is the full step two. I'm up and roll. I try to stop that bow in my center. One more time. And from behind, one, two. Again, stopping it right here. It's tough. Sometimes it's going to swing past a little bit, but what you're going to want to do is really get that strength built up, forearms and wrists, to be able to stop it. Okay, so I'm going to come behind and roll. To really build your momentum, we started out on our side. Now we're going to start out in the front. Okay, like I have a reverse punch going here, up, forearms up. So I'm starting out and two, and one, two. Okay, let's add the toss and we'll get the full combination together. Okay, so I have here one, behind, wrist roll, and release. When I do my release, you want to think about it just like you're doing your wrist roll. It's the same science behind it. We're pushing off with our wrist and our thumb. Okay, here. And toss. And again, timing is key. All right? That's something I always tell all my students. Your timing is so important on your catch and consistency on your release. Sometimes if you toss it and release it one time and then maybe four times, it's going to be hard to catch it. So be consistent and have good timing. All right, so let's take it together. I'm in front. One. Two. One more time. Full combination. And catch. And from behind. Now, there's two things you can do with this. You can use it as a warm-up, or you can use it as what's called floating your bow. I'm going to show you how to do the warm-up first, and then we're going to float it. Okay, so the warm-up is just simply taking your bow from a behind-the-back wrist roll toss and just keep doing it and looping it like this. Just nice and smooth, nothing high, just right in front of your body, just like this. It just gets your body warmed up. Okay, I'll show from behind. So then that way you get used to doing your releases and all of your passes. And you can start slow and then build fast. Okay, so you can just keep escalating as you go through. Now to make your bow float. All right, this is really making it go in the air so you can execute moves like spins, double spins, triple spins with your bow staff. So we're going to go ahead and do the float now. So I'm going to take it behind. I'm going to do my wrist roll, and when I do this, I take it a little bit higher. I really release it up. And all that does, it's not a fast spin, it's a floating spin, bigger and higher. So behind and float. Okay, so from the rear view, behind and float. And one more time, behind and float. So those are all the different variations and drills that you can use for your behind-the-back wrist roll to release. Next up is what's called our tornado kick pass. We're going to break this down into three steps where we're going to do just the tornado kick, then into the tornado kick clap, and then into the full tornado kick pass. So for our first two, we don't need our bow staff, so we'll go ahead and put it to the side, out of our way. So your tornado kick, sometimes called a wheel kick in some karate schools, is an intermediate to advanced level technique, but something that you want to make sure you're really smooth when you throw it. Okay, so I'm going to demonstrate it forward and demonstrate it back. Okay, I'm going to move my left knee and whip through with my right leg. So here, one, and two. Okay, now forward, I'm gonna turn, pushing off this knee, following through with this kick. Okay? All this is a knee. This is the only leg that kicks. You're right. So I'm coming across and kicking. One more time from behind. Set. Turn. And kick. And one more time from front. Set. Turn. And kick. So now let's go to step two, which is called the clap. All right, what you're going to do is you're going to clap your hands underneath your legs as you go and throw your kick. What this does is it helps you simulate passing the bow underneath your leg, which you're going to do, and also helps you get your timing down so that way when you're kicking, you know exactly when you're going to pass it. So I'll demonstrate forward and back. I'm straight, turn, and kick. And from behind, straight, turn, and kick. Now, what you want to make sure you do with your bow is you have to keep it completely sideways, just like this. Do not let it go vertically because it's going to line straight up with your kick. Okay? You've got to make sure that it's horizontal because that's how it's going to pass underneath your leg. So now let me take you through this in a really slow step process. I'm just going to do no jumping, okay, and just take the steps and pass under my leg. I'll demonstrate forward first. I'm just going to turn, bring my knee up, and then pass the bow from left to right. I'm going to do it this way. Turn. Knee up, pass. Make sure that when you pass, again, getting it all the way underneath and switching right here. So now let me do it with the full kick at about a medium pace. So I set with my hands gripping up, knuckles up. I come across my body and turn and pass from left to right. Now from behind, I set, turn, and pass. One more time from each angle. Okay, I'll do it on our side angle as well. So straight, again, hands up or hands in traditional grip, either one. I prefer knuckles out so I can twist. So one, two, from side view, and one, two, and from reverse view, and one, two. That is your tornado kick pass for competition bow staff. Next up, we're going to move into our three different variations of our neck rolls. Okay? We have our first two are our straight neck rolls, where we bring it out and around. So that was left and right. And then we have our full neck roll, where we bring it completely around. Okay, so let's break the first two down, and then we'll move on to our third. Our neck roll is the easiest way to learn it is to bend over. This is what I teach everybody when they're first beginning learning these. You want to bend down just like this, okay? And you're going to allow your bow to float over your head, okay? Right around your neck. So what you want to do is your hand positioning. You want to take your right hand, if you're doing the left, okay? And put it up by your ear, just like this. Right hand up by the ear. And then cross your arms. It may feel like you're putting yourself in a headlock All right, but this is how you want to be in order to be able to get this move down immediately. So bend down, cross those arms, and just roll it over. Pretty simple. For today's purposes, I'm going to be demonstrating most of the stuff with the left hand. What you want to do, if your left hand is going to be your neck roll hand, that means you're right hand dominant. Okay, so I'm a right-handed person, so I'm going to be using my left to do my neck rolls because where I grab, I feel more comfortable with my more dominant hand. I'm used to using this more, so that's the hand I want to catch with. So keep that in mind when you're deciding which side that you want to do your neck roll on. So again, I'm going to demonstrate everything with the left side. Okay, so again, bend down, bring it up by the ear, cross the arms, and just roll it over. Very simply, one more time from a different angle, bend down, cross, and roll. Okay. So now we'll do it standing up. I'm just going to take my arm out. The same idea. Bring it up and pass. So from behind, so you can follow, out, hand up by the ear, and pass. It's pretty tough to keep the bow completely straight, but that's really what you want to shoot for. If you get your bow staff moving like down on angles, it's going to have a tendency to fall off of your head, okay, and fall off of your shoulders and off of your neck. So you want to make sure to keep it straight as possible. So one more time on the left roll. I'm out, up, and around. Again, that is the first step, and the second step would just be using your right hand. Okay, so I'll demonstrate that one time through. This isn't as my dominant side, but you want to practice both sides just so if you're doing combinations later in more advanced moves, in your more advanced forms, that you can be able to move in and out of those techniques. So again, I'll try with the right side. One and two. Okay, one more time. Left and pass. And right, and pass. Okay, so now we're going to go on to the full neck roll. This one is a little bit more difficult and something that's going to take more practice. So instead of pointing your bow out, like we were with our knuckles up, we're going to take our bow, grab it on our side, and we're going to put it on our shoulder like so. Okay, so again, my fist pointing out. All right, so the difference is here. Neck roll one, neck roll two. This is your full neck roll. So I'm going to take it. Same premise can apply where we bend down. All right, and I roll it. All right, so let's get that hand up by our ear like we've already learned and bring it around and grab. For this one, it's hard to keep your hand up there the entire time because it does a full rotation. As you saw on the first one, we're just doing a pass, just a one little half turn. On this one, we do a full neck roll. So let me demonstrate from behind. I've got the bow up on my shoulders. I bring my hand up and grab. So one more time, up and grab. So our three steps. Left, right, and full. One more time from behind. Left, right, and full. Those are your neck roll variations for competition bow staff. Now we're going to move on to some of our intermediate striking combinations. Our first intermediate strike combination takes in a few things that we learned in our Volume 1 beginner video, okay, and places them in now. What we're going to do is we're going to take our figure eight and spin, which is something that we learned in our first video, and place that in with a striking combo variation. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to start out on our side, just like this, in a regular gripping position. Right is up, left is down, standard grip. So I'm going to do my figure eight spin. I'm going to bring it up. Twirl and spin. Remember, as we went over in volume one, that you want to spin as your figure eight comes on a down motion. Okay, again, on a downward motion, I'm one, and here it's getting ready to come down. That's when I'm going to spin. Okay, so I set on my side and twirl. Now, as I'm coming over, I'm going to drop to my knee, and I'm going to bring my bow over my shoulder and strike the ground. Okay, I'll demonstrate that one more time. I'm going to twirl, spin. Now, as you see, I slide my left hand, bringing it down. So let me demonstrate that from behind. I'm twirling, bringing it down. So let me do it a little bit faster now. Set. Now we're going to finish the combination. Set on my side. I bring it up. Twirl. Down. And back. And finish. Again, I come back. And finish. Stopping my bow right on my shoulder on the side. So let me demonstrate it from behind. Set. Twirl. Down. Back and finish. So a little bit faster from the front angle. From behind. What this move does is really gives you a great dynamic transition from up to down to back up. If you break it down, you've got a figure eight to spin, which is a great intermediate move. Then you've got an overstrike, a different manipulation on your bow. Then you're back up into a side stance and finish. So you're showing speed, dynamic transition from the knee, and power on the end. Okay, so one more time from both angles, near full speed. Time. That's your intermediate strike combination one. Great job on intermediate strike combination one. Now as we move on to strike combination two, we're going to remember speed, power, and dynamic technique. All right, in this combination, we're going to get all of that. So we're going to strike on an angle, finish on an angle. So we're going to strike across our body. One, two, three. So basic strikes again. I'm set. One, two, three. Now, as I come across to my next strike, I'm going to bring my knee up and hit. Okay, so I'll do that a little bit slower. One, two, three, four, five. One more time. And one, two, three, four, five. Then we add six across our body. So we have starting on an angle, ending on an angle. Let's work that again. From behind this time. And one, two, three, four, five, six. And from the front, a little faster. And one, two, three, four, five, six. From behind. And one, two, three, four, five, six. Now as we put the ending on it, we're going to take our figure eight spin technique that we just worked on in intermediate strike combo one. We're going to go to our knee and we're going to end with a really strong down strike. So let's take this all together. One, two, three, four, five, six. Now we go with our figure eight. Bringing it up. Again, from here. Up. And twirl. One more time. From here. Twirl and spin. Go down to my knee. Hit. Back. Down. And pull. All right? So let me take that last part really slow. I'm on my strike. And twirl, down, back, hit, pull. Let me do it from behind now. Strike, and twirl, down, up, back, hit, and pull. So let's do it a little bit faster so you can kind of see what the whole thing looks like at about an intermediate pace. Okay, now we add the knee. One more time. And now we add the end. Figure eight, hit, back, and finish. Okay, one more time from the front view, then we will go from behind. So, strike, two, three, four, five, six, figure eight, hit, back, down, and pull. This motion is a stab and a pull. Some of you may feel a little bit more comfortable coming stab and pull, kind of get your hips into it. So you can do that. So from down, back, and pull. Whichever you feel more comfortable with. So now I'll go from behind, set, and strike. Two, three, four, five, six, and figure eight. Down, back, hit, and pull. Again, if I want to move that knee, I come from down, back, hit, and pull. So one more time, the full combination, intermediate level two. That's at about an intermediate pace, and you really want to practice that to get all of your dynamic changes and transitions down really clean, because we're going from angle to angle, to knee, to finish. So that's your intermediate level strike combo two. Before we move on to intermediate strike combination number three, we need to learn how to do our baseball bat swing from a one-hand or two-hand position. So we're going to start off with our two-hand baseball swing. We're going to bring our hands down on our bow staff near the bottom. Okay, so I have one hand about two fist distances away. One, two. So one more time, as you can see. One, two. And then I have my other hand. One, two, three fist distances away from the other. Right, so this is my position when I'm gripping on my bow for my two-hand baseball bat swing. So I want to set with my bow up high, and I'm going to bring it back behind me and rest it on my shoulder. One, two, and I'm going to swing slowly as I come through. So one more time, slow. And up, turn, and around. Okay, so let's see it a little faster. Set, and through. One more time. Set, and through. What I want to do is make sure that I spin and swing as hard as I can. But at the same time, I have a solid grip on my bow. You don't want to be letting go of it when you're swinging on your baseball bat swing. Okay, so one more time, I'll set from the beginning. One, two, and spin. Now on to our one hand, even more important. That's why I'll wipe my hands off, that we have a tight grip on our bow staff when we're doing our one-hand baseball bat swing. This is normally started from the same position, one hand resting down, then we bring it up on our shoulder and swing through. All right, so again, one, two, and three. So let's take this together, two hand and one hand. I'm set, slowly bring it up, swing, swing. So I see I did 2-1. So I'm set, and 1-2. One more time. I'm set, and through. When I do my baseball bat swings, again, all my power is coming from my shoulders, biceps, triceps, forearms, wrists. Everything is in my upper body here and swinging across. This is a good warm-up to do right here when you're getting these down. Bringing it across. Okay, it's a good full-body warm-up. So those are your one-hand and two-hand baseball bat swings. Now let's move on to combination number three. To wrap up our intermediate volume on my rock solid video series for competition bow staff, we're going to finish up with our strike combo number three. This is going to take in our swing, our baseball bat swing that we just learned, into a jump strike and finish onto the knee. So let's break it down into three steps. We're going to start out, again, we just learned through our baseball bat swing. So I'm in my gripping position here. I'm going to bring it up and swing through. And as I come through, my hand needs to slide, my right hand, so I can strike. So let me take that slow again. I'm up in my ready position, bring it back, and I need to swing on that straight line. Now I bring my bow around, and I slide this right hand, as you see. One more time. So after I've done my swing, I'm here and I'm bringing it around and I'm striking. So a little bit faster, set, and I hit. This is gonna set us up for our next step. I'm in my set position. This is one, two, on the strike. And then we're going into the jump. So the jump, what we're going to do is you're going to take your feet, bring them close together. So one more time. They don't have to be all the way together, but just bring them close, like so. All right? So I was at my swing, hit, feet. And we're going to jump off from both feet, just like this, off of both knees. All right? So let me put my bow down so I can show you the footing on that. Just watch my feet as I step into this. I'm in my side stance. I'm turning front stance together, and I'm bringing both knees up just like that. Okay? So I'm kicking those feet up towards my back. So let me demonstrate the combination full out one time, and then we'll break it down again. So I'm set and hit. Okay? What you may have seen my bow do is after I strike, I'm bringing my bow up above my head. Okay? Like I'm raising it back, drawing it up, and finishing my opponent. So let's take it slow. Step one. two. And here we go, three, and I raise it up, and after my jump, I end straight down. Okay, so again, I'm raising that bow up and dropping it down. So let's take it about an intermediate pace now. And go. Okay, either knee, you can end with the right forward or end with the left forward. Whichever you prefer, all it's going to do is matter on your transition out of this, which I will show you now. You can either move left foot to strike, or if it's right, here, turn and strike. So let's take it all together. I'm at my set position one, two, jump, three, and finish. Let's watch it full out one time. I'm going to demonstrate on a straight angle and then from the other side. I'm at my draw. I'm set. You see, I gave that little pause there. I would have my ki strike here, boom, and finish it again. So now from this angle, so you can kind of see a different view, I'm at my draw, and that is your intermediate strike combination number three. As we come to the conclusion of my second rock solid video series on competition bow staff, I'd like to thank you for viewing and congratulate you on being one step closer to becoming a world champion. I encourage you to pick up my other videos as we're going to cover more explosive, dynamic, creative, and difficult techniques that are going to take you one step closer to becoming the best. Again, I'm available for private lessons and seminars via my contact information that's listed right after my video. I look forward to seeing you in my next video, and congratulations on an excellent performance.